What's up, guys? Today we're gonna check out the new Xbox wireless headset from Microsoft. We finally have a shiny new first party headset to go along with that shiny new Xbox Series S and X. You can pick this up for $100 US, 130 Canadian, or £90 if you're in the UK. That's essentially the same price as the PS5 headset. Now, although you can Bluetooth this with your phone and other devices, it's really designed for Xbox consoles and Windows 10. It's packaged similar to how Microsoft packages their controllers, just in a bigger box. The top swings open and the headset is displayed right on top. Before we look at the headset in detail, let's see what's underneath here. Here's the printed material, user manual, safety guide. Here's a USB-C cable for charging the headset, so yeah, it's rechargeable. And thank God, I'm so used to seeing AA batteries coming right out of the controller boxes. And the headset, it's all black with these green accents that match really well with the Series X. Maybe in the future they'll release a white one or other colors. First impressions, I'm really digging the look and the feel of this thing. The build quality, it's pretty premium for a $100 headset. I do prefer the adjustable headband that this thing has over what Sony delivers on their headset. All of the cushions also feel a lot softer. So at least in the physical form, it definitely looks and feels really, really good. Also, it does have this flexible mic, which should work well and better than a built-in mic. Let's go ahead and set this up. Before you do though, just make sure it's fully charged. Behind the red ear cup is the green power button. Press it to power the headset on. Pairing it with your console is really simple. It's just like how you pair a controller. Press the sync button on the Xbox console and hold this green button for 4 seconds on the headset. You can see the lights are flashing indicating that it's in pairing mode, and once it's paired, it'll go solid. You do get a message on the screen here indicating that the headset is paired. Just like the controller, the headset also receives updates. And the first time you connect it, there is a small update that's required. Now, in addition to the power button, there's 3 other adjustments on the physical headset. Right here, there is a mute button for the mic. And you can see the light indicator here on the mic also shows the on-off status for that mute. Also, keep in mind the headset has auto mute, so that'll automatically mute your mic when you're not talking. On the right ear cup, you can turn this knob to increase or decrease the volume. And the third setting is on the left ear cup. There's a second audio balance knob. You can adjust the balance between the game's audio and the voice chat. What's neat with this adjustment is at the 50-50 balance, the center point, the knob actually clicks into place. Another great feature of the headset is how it works with the Xbox Accessories app. You can highly customize how the headset sounds using that app. And that's pretty much a priceless feature if you enjoy fine-tuning your audio. Overall, I'm gonna go ahead and say Microsoft hit it out of the park with this headset. At that $100 price point, it should be on the top of your list if you need a headset for your Series S or X. While playing Fortnite, I love turning the knobs quickly to make adjustments to the audio.
You woke me up in a bad mood and now you still have a bad mood.
This headset is also extremely comfortable. The only downside is that it's not compatible with any other console other than Xbox. So no, you can't use this with your PS5. It also doesn't have a built-in 3.5mm audio cable output. So you cannot use it with your old phone or the Nintendo Switch. And with that, that's it for today. Hope that helps you make a decision on if you should pick this headset up. Let me know in the comments what you think. And don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel, because there's a ton of Xbox, PlayStation, and Nintendo Switch content coming your way.